In this video, I'll talk about the benefits and applications of polymer powder bed fusion. The advantages of polymer powder bed fusion are that we need no support structures, and that gives us tremendous design freedom. I point out this example of these little ducts that go in here. If you would need support structure, you would never get them out. Would be impossible to make. Maybe with, or it would be doable with dissolvable support, but then you need a lot of excess material. Another example that I haven't shown before, I've shown this assembly, is also this turbine. It's a little demonstrator from EOS. Comes out of the printer like that, only the particles are dusted off in between, and then it's able to rotate. And the little bucky bobblehead. And this is actually out of a nylon 12. So it can manufacture parts in standard plastics with good mechanical properties. I've shown you, told you, it's not that all the thermoplastics and semicrystalline polymers in the world can be used, but it's a good variety of technical thermoplastics. So because it can be used for structural parts, it has a variety of materials to choose from. Structural parts are also possible because of its isotropic behavior. We don't see a huge difference in the strengths and modulus in different directions of the part. In fact, depending on the process parameters, you reach 80 to 95% of the properties of a homogeneous ejection molded part. There's more and more development in materials. The price becomes very competitive for small lots. You get a lot of parts into that part cake. So all the time you need to heat up and cool, you divide that by the number of parts, and that makes it interesting. And the powder from the part cake can be refreshed. Industry uses up to 70% of the recycled material and mix it with 30 virgin and reuse it that way. So you don't lose all that, that loose powder that wasn't used in a build. However, disadvantages that in that case, the powder is expensive and the unused powder is prone to degradation. That's why we're not using all of it. We're doing the refreshing. Wall thicknesses of bigger than 300 micrometers are possible. Walls should be built horizontally rather than vertically because of step structures that we get in there. And parts do not have exactly the same properties as the injection molded counterparts. So we're not there yet. The tolerances and surface finishes are good, but we have a powdery texture. So it feels a little rough, which compared to VAT photopolymerization, where it's super smooth, the surface finish here is good, but not like injection molding. VAT photopolymerization is much closer to injection molding surfaces. And the powder in the reservoirs have different density from top to bottom, which affects the deposited amount and some other things. So there's a lot of detail understanding necessary to run a good build and get high quality parts out of. Some of the applications, we have seen huge developments in aerospace, in appliances, and in fashion. Aerospace, already some years ago, we had more than 20,000 flying parts. 200 different part numbers and 10 different platforms. Platforms means different manufacturing technologies from different suppliers, but also different technologies, for example, powder, polymer, and metal. So we have this strut here that Stratus has made for Boeing. And then appliances, we have spare part production, white parts. It's just a lot more expensive to put an injection mold in the machine, injection mold thousands of parts that you don't know if they're going to be used and when, and put that in storage, then make the spare part on demand when it's really needed. And then in fashion, we see the new Balance midsoles here and these pretty cool glasses here. The Lux Excel are fully printed glasses where the optics are also printed with material jetting, which we'll talk about a little later. So very cool applications, structural parts, even glasses need to have a high strength that you don't, when you drop it, they're still intact. So this is really a process with polymer powder bed fusion that allows you to make structural parts with very good properties.